Schedule you have, I got a plan for you.
All right.
Lord, you might not be in agreement with it, but amen, praise God, I got a plan for you, amen, to get what you need and to receive the word and prayer. All right, amen. All right, we're going to start recording our prayers on Monday night. I'm going to start praying tomorrow night, amen, for a whole week. Amen. This is going to be a consecration week. And somebody said, we would be able to eat. All right, well, just keep on listening. Amen, your appetite almost ought to be gone, almost be gone now. Glory, glory, because the scripture is very plain when it says that when they ate to the full, then what? They ate to the full and God sent leanness to their soul. This was speaking about the children of Israel. So there's no way that you can eat every meal, never have seasons of what? Where you would push back the plate. See, Daniel, even early, before he even was launching his 60-year-old ministry, he purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with the what? King's meat. So he figured that there was a certain way that he would have to what? Eat to maintain his what? Spiritual focus and his values. Otherwise, you can almost eat everything you ever stood for away. You can just eat it up. Just eat. Yeah, amen. Praise God. And we don't nearly need to be eating it every meal. Amen. One of these Sundays, I'm going to take time, and I'm going to show you why so many people die suddenly. Because a lot of things we do, if we keep doing them, it's going to bring our bodies, our homeostasis, that's our body, the balance. The blood has to have a certain balance. And whenever it gets too much junk and stuff like we like to do, then it begins to lose that balance and the blood begins to get full of impurities, toxins and poison, our cells get clogged up, and that pulls our bodies out of homeostasis. And when it gets a little bit out of balance, you could die just like that. You could just die instantly. And sometimes we hear people that died instantly. It's a devil. They were the picture of hell. They just went and got a what? A clean bill of health from the doctor. And see, God has already designed a way for us to keep our bodies from getting oversaturated with poisons and toxins, which are the main cause of all sicknesses and diseases. And this is what sicknesses and diseases breed on. So fasting, doing without, pulling back from a whole lot of the foods that we're eating, especially acidic foods, these are the things that's going to help to get your body in a physical condition where you can begin to experience a much higher quality of health and you begin to feel better. In other words, you start feeling like praying. How many believe that you can get so, eat so many wrong different things? Y'all don't follow me. And you can sit down and eat so much meat and desserts and starches and stuff that you like until 30 minutes after, boy, you're going to be what? You're going to be so what? Devitalized, and your energy is going to be what? Zap. And after a while, you say, and I believe that one of the reasons why prayer becomes so difficult, many times the reason why, many times our attention span is so low, is because of the condition of our bodies. Many of us, if we really understood where we are physically, amen, you would be absolutely alarmed. If you could just get your body pH and see how acidic possibly you are. And the acidic condition is the thing that causes all of the what? Sicknesses and diseases. I went back home, I couldn't believe some of the leading people, college professors, people that are having strokes. I mean, one of the major pastors there, I mean, not a major pastor, but he was a pastor that I knew, married him 38 years ago. And his wife was in a wheelchair with a stroke. One of the leading pastors there, he just recovered from a stroke. And these people are people just like you and I. Amen. So God is saying that he wants us to what? Get back to that sincere, pure devotion. You can't eat anything you want anytime you want to eat. Amen. There's a period of time that you need to what? You need to absolutely, amen, push that plate what? Back. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. How many are willing to, amen, praise God, to really tone down things so you can get, amen, better, get better in tune with God? I mean, we better tone down some stuff. Is that right? So my suggestion this week is that I want to make sure that everybody's on the same page. So I want everybody to do the chapter, Having God's Interest at Heart. We're trying to get everybody back on one accord. This is in the profile of a true disciple. I mean, that book has it all about prayer, all the different kinds of prayer. It's everything. Amen. Everything that you need to be on track. And it's just like Pastor Hill teaching you in your bedroom. All you have to do is read. And that's the reason why I want you to push your plate back so you won't be so tired and devitalized. You won't have all of these, what, acid pains, indigestion pains, bloating. So that you can what? Pay attention.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Having, everybody just say, having God's interest at heart. Amen. So that's the problem that we're having in churches everywhere. Amen. Having God's interest at heart. See, okay, this is chapter 2. This is chapter 2. I want everybody just to start there because I want you to work this, read through it. Amen. Praise God. We want to get back because all of this information is designed to kind of get you back walking the straight and narrow path, following the example of Jesus, and doing basic foundational things that you need to do in order to really begin to experience a greater measure of God's anointing. And the chapter that we're actually doing now is chapter 4. So you're going to have to work up to 4. Amen. We got lessons, the blanks. Every chapter has what? Questions. And you have to what? Work lessons out. Amen. How many don't want to be in no college? So I said, just Pastor, you just tell me something. Amen. Just tell me something. Amen. But the Lord told me that saints now are so far off, this is everywhere, until unless they pin themselves down and get involved in something systematic, something that's written down, and something that's structured, but they have to read it and what? Look the answer up in the questions, amen, and write it down. And after you read it, work it out, write down the answer, then there's got to be a way to check you to see if you did it. That's going to be hard to do. Amen. So I'm thinking about getting some of y'all back on Sunday evening because there's too many of y'all missing Bible class. We'll have to do something. We're either going to get it right. We're either going to have to what? Get, amen, the information and get the training, the need, whatever we're needed in order for us to be able to what? To articulate the plan of redemption, of salvation. Well, I got so much information that we could be utilizing now in terms of leading people to Christ, leading people to the Holy Spirit, counteracting all of the objections and that people have. Amen. Praise God. If we could get the foundation established, this is what we're talking about today. Get our foundation established, we could be a lot more effective. Now, I'm even thinking about very shortly, I want to ordain some ministers. I want to ordain some elders. I'm going to do that real soon. Amen. And some deacon and deaconesses. But see, anybody that's going to be in a position, in a role, we need to master things that dealing with the basic foundation of stuff. So I think that there's nothing that you could focus on that's more important than having God's interest at heart. It's hard, you know, so people think that it comes automatically when you get saved into the Holy Spirit. I'm automatically going to be interested in what? And sharing with people, loving people, and ministering to them, and helping them, and blessing them, and praying for them, and interceding for them, and dealing. That does not come automatically. There are some disciplines, there are some things that you have to what? Apply yourself to, commit to, before that interest and that desire and that motivation to work with people and to help people. So you gotta, amen, you gotta a ministry, or you have a call on your life. Amen. Scripture says we are God's what? Workmanship, created unto Christ for what? Unto good works. That is the That is the number one reason why you are saved. Suppose we miss that. Suppose we miss the mainest thing. That's not good English, is it, Sister Hill? Suppose we miss the mainest thing. What do you think you're going to end up? Some say, well, I just fake it until I make it. We need to have God's interest in heart. In other words, we got to be interested in what? The souls and the salvation of lost men. And most times, when the cares of life, the deceitfulness of riches, and all that we go through, have a busy schedule, amen, we got to take care of this, take care of that, do this, do that, do that or other, and then after, when we're not doing all of that, then we're eating. See, there's no chance that what? The interest in the things of God is going to be kindled. So the Lord told me to slow y'all down. I'm going to pray with you this week, John. I'm going to pray. Can you put all these prayers on YouTube? All right. Y'all tune in after tomorrow night on YouTube, and we're going to start you praying. All right. Start tomorrow night.
All right.
Amen. Some said, well, I just do YouTube. I won't worry about coming to pray. But if you can come out here to pray. All right. Amen. Now, having God's interest at heart. I have about maybe 7 or 8 of those books, but most of y'all should have them, and it's about time for y'all to take them out and read them and work them out. Well, I've never seen anything like this in all of my days. Boy, you can have everything at people's fingertips, and they still don't have time to do it. Won't take time. That means that what? That we'll never have God's interest in heart. Amen. I'm just about done. I'm just talking off the top of my head. There's a lot of scriptures I could have. Amen. Could have read, because I wrote down a lot of scriptures in a whole lot of different areas. But the Lord just told me to get y'all back on the right track. Now, a lot of people, members of this church, they don't come to no prayer. People in leadership roles and doing stuff in the church. And almost, I could say the same thing about no Bible study. That's got to change. Amen. If you can't be here in person, amen, it's going to be your responsibility to go over or to read, I mean, to to recall or to retrieve everything that went on Wednesday night. Your responsibility. One way, the best way, probably to do it is to do the book. Amen. We're going right straight to it. Through. 2, 3, 4. Everybody can capitalize. 2, 3, 4. Read it again, because the life of the saints of God is what? Leaving. Sometimes I feel scary in this place. Oh, Jesus. Amen. If it takes 14 days, 7 days, 14 days, I'm just going to put y'all maybe just a few days. But amen. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, amen. Those are days I want you to set aside for consecration. All right, write it down. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So what we want you to do, we want you to just drink water. And we don't want nobody coming out with no flu or virus, nothing like that. And so if you want to take vitamin C, immune thing, if you want to keep from coming down with something, or you can do fresh fruits and vegetables. But more than likely, if you can do vitamin C or some type of immune formulation, more than likely you won't hardly come down with anything. And for those that drink the condom water, they've probably got enough in it without anything other than the water. If you want a stronger antioxidant, you can go the 11.5. If you want a stronger, you won't come down. If you got a flu or virus, you know, you can get rid of that. Amen. So this week, we want to begin to get back in land. How many appreciate Pastor trying to save you before it's too late? Amen. How many appreciate Pastor trying to save you before it's too late? Amen. Because of the way we're going, amen, praise God, we won't be able to what? Even to save ourselves. And if you can't save yourself, amen, you know you're not going to be able to what? Save nobody else. God wants us to have what? A little bit more than just enough for ourselves, right? He wants our cups to be what? Running over. Amen. And the only way that we can get our cups run over, we're going to have to what? Put something in there. Is that right?
Yeah.
Amen. You're going to have to put something in the cup. Amen. And we're going to start out with the word. Now, I almost forget this. I don't want to forget this. This is the biggest. All right. We want you to work through lessons 2. If you don't have a book, see me. Quick. See me. If I have to let you have it on credit, but you better pay me. Amen. Work these lessons out. Time out. Preaching to people. They don't take notes. If they take them, they don't read them. Time is out. We're going to have to what? Get something structured. Day by day. Look up these scriptures. Write down these answers. Answer these questions. Amen. And make sure, amen, praise God, these questions are discussed. And we'll make sure that they'll be discussed. They'll get you here, or we'll find a way. Some of us, I might have to call you up just to check, just to see, amen, if you can answer these things. I don't want to take you too close. But I'm really interested in you getting prepared, because we need ministers, we need deacons in this church that's capable of what? Amen. Of helping out. Amen. There's no point in I'm the only one that ever talk about prayer, that promote it. I want a whole group of people, amen, working together, and everybody believing in prayer, and everybody promoting it, and everybody practicing it. We can have a strong church. Now, I go to a lot of places, and most churches do that. They do not have any of the things that we have in terms of information, the workbooks, the notebooks. We got everything. You know, when I talk to a pastor, I say, I have enough information for you, for your ministry, that will give you everything basically you need up to 5 years. And I guarantee you, it will carry them every bit of 5 years. And that information is in your closet, in your bookshelves, laying around somewhere. So it's about time that you have what? Locate it, retrieve it, dust it off. Is that right, Brother Beauty? Amen. And we're going to start, amen, getting very, very serious. This week we're just going to do with the lessons and the fasting. Everybody said the lessons and the fasting. And the month of March, we want everybody to read, because this goes right along with the lessons, the book of Luke. No, the book of St. John. St. John is the book. St. John is the book. Because we're talking about the works of Jesus. Everybody said the month of March, the book of what? Now, when can we start on that? The book of St. John. Sister Pearl said, "Now," she said, "I guess I really already hyped up." She said, "Now, all right, the book of St. John. See, we need to be reading straight from the Bible too. Is that right? How many can say amen?" Now I'm going to tell you right now, the information that I'm not going to pass out until Sister Pearl puts the final touches on it, but all of the sermons, the Lord's compassion, we have perfected that, the Lord's compassion. These are considered as the part of the scripture that you can study and read that will build your faith to the highest level possible. I mean, that's where you start. Amen. If you really want to begin to focus on getting your faith at the mountain peak high. How many remember all the scriptures, I mean all the teaching we did on the Lord's compassion? And we're going to follow that by teaching grace. And that is basically dealing with who we are in Christ. And those are the scriptures, of the teachings that we're going to be focusing on this year, that will absolutely get you in place, in position to be effective in terms of ministering and doing the works of Jesus and actually fulfilling your mission as a believer. Amen. We're getting them the Country Club Plaza ministry, hopefully started this month. Amen. The ministry with the marriage and family. I want to keep you just 1 minute and ask, we're trying to get a time that we can set up this teaching on the weekend. This is for family. This is what is it called? Marriage and family? The Art of Marriage. Okay. We want everybody to view it, because some of us are going to have to carry out and promote it so that we can get the people that really we want to come in and do it. So that we got to know, can we do it on a Friday night and a Saturday? Or do we have to do it at some other times, maybe on a Sunday when more people could be exposed to it? Because we want all young couples, everybody in a relationship, everybody that need to know more about a relationship. Amen. We want you involved. I know my time is about out. And also, there are other ministries that we just want to get started, but we want to get everybody first on the same page. Everybody just say on the same page. How many feel like your assignment is enough for right now? All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So there will be some fasting and prayer this week. Everybody say fasting and prayer. And the fasting will be, we can get off all of the acid stuff, and we want to get on alkaline. That means get on what? If you want fresh juice, the fresh fruit, that will be about the limit of it. If you want to take some vitamins that's organic or that's not from the drugstore, amen, you can take those. Amen. So the fasting and prayer, amen, is going to be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And I'm almost tempted, amen, to call a prayer meeting. Amen. Look how y'all looking at me. Amen. We'll just throw it out there for Friday night to break our fast. Amen. But I'm just interested in God's people coming back to the place where God really can work through them, and they can actually experience, amen, the true Spirit of Christ and the real anointing and the motivation and the zeal and the fervency and the brokenness. I want to see God's people going forth weeping, bearing precious seeds, and then coming again with rejoicing, bringing their seeds with them. Amen. We got to do something, saints, because Jesus is coming, what? Real soon. Amen. Some things happening nation worldwide now to let you know that the door is almost closed. Our time that God has allowed us is almost done. Look at the nation Russia. Look at the nation China. Look at Iran. All of these players are in prophecy. And something is about to happen. And I think that we ought to be what? Getting ready for whatever comes. Because we don't know the day or the hour that the what? Lord comes. But he said for us to be what? He said for us to be what?
Ready.
He said for us to be what?
Ready.
Amen. How do we get ready? Like not just being empty-headed, but we got to what? Fill our heads, fill our hearts. Is that right? Get something in us. Get some motivation. Wake up. Get in the flow. Whatever the Lord told us to do, we're going to have to what? Do that. Amen. I'm done. I want everybody to stand because I think that this is much more serious than most of us.